Yes, this is a pencil. It has been there for me when I drew some of my most beautiful work. But here's food for thought. My pencil has something in common with me, and it's here, at its tip. And it's carbon. Yeah, carbon. The tip is made of graphite. And graphite is a crystalline form of the element carbon, with its atoms arranged in an hexagonal structure. And carbon is one of the main elements found in all living things, like me and you. We are walking Lego structures, with blocks of carbon-based molecules that build almost every structure in our body, and also carry out most of the processes that keep us alive. To understand what a carbon-based molecule is, we need to, well, meet carbon first. Carbon is an inorganic and organic atom. It is inorganic when found in some carbon-based substances that you probably are familiar with, like coal, petroleum, diamonds, and the graphite in your pencil. And it is considered organic when it binds to hydrogen and forms important molecules found in living things. But more on that later. Carbon-based molecules, commonly known as organic molecules, are so important that science has devoted a whole discipline to their study. It is called organic chemistry. But what is so special about carbon? Remember that carbon is element number 6 on the periodic table. That atomic number 6 means that each atom of carbon has 6 protons in its nucleus. And that means that every normal or neutral carbon atom has 6 electrons as well. Electrons orbit the atom's nucleus, like planets orbit the sun, at various distances from the nucleus. We call these orbits energy shells. The number of energy shells that a particular atom has depends on its number of electrons. Carbon has 2 energy shells. The innermost shell contains 2 of its electrons, while the outer shell holds the remaining 4 electrons. And it is those 4 tiny electrons that make carbon so special. You see, every atom of carbon has the ability to share each of its 4 electrons with 4 other atoms, thereby forming up to 4 covalent bonds. For example, one atom of carbon can bond to 4 different atoms of hydrogen, forming the gas methane. Likewise, one atom of carbon can form a bond with another atom of carbon, so 2 carbon atoms bound together, while those same carbons form bonds with 3 molecules of hydrogen each, making what we know as the gas ethane. Now, it is carbon's ability to bond to itself and to other molecules like hydrogen that is the basis of organic chemistry. And because carbon can form bonds with itself, long chains of carbon atoms with their associated hydrogen atoms form in nature. We said that carbon can bind to itself, right? So the ends of those carbon chains can flip around and bind together, thus forming rings. For example, a ring containing 6 carbons and their associated hydrogens and hydroxyl groups is the very well-known and simple sugar known as glucose. Likewise, carbon chains can link together and thereby forming branched chains. Now, to take this idea a step further, check this out. Carbon chains can bind to carbon rings, forming large sheets resembling chain link fences. Now, let's reconsider our new friend, glucose. As we know by now, glucose is a carbon-based molecule, so it should be able to form bonds with other glucose molecules, right? And the answer is yes! In this case, a single unit of glucose is called a monomer. Mono meaning one, and so the word monomer means one unit. Many monomers of glucose can bind together to form long chains, and even branching chains of glucose. Lots of glucose molecules bound together can form huge molecules known as glycogen, starch, or cellulose. Collectively, those big molecules are called polymers. Poly meaning many. So polymer refers to many units. And therein lies one important rule concerning carbon-based structures. Polymers are formed by monomers. And the existence of monomers and polymers allows a diversity of functions for carbon-based molecules in life. For example, glucose as a single unit or a monomer can be used by our bodies to produce energy. Glucose can then be stored by the liver as glycogen, which is basically a bunch of glucose molecules neatly packed together. Let's say this is nature's response to Marie Kondo. As I mentioned before, all life on planet Earth is based on carbon-based or organic molecules. There are four major classes of organic molecules important to life. We're talking about carbohydrates, lipids, proteins, and nucleic acids. Each of these types of organic molecules have monomers and polymers. Imagine each category of molecules as a box set of Legos made of many pieces, or monomers, that can come together to form one major structure, or a polymer. In this video, we've already mentioned glucose as an example of a monomer for carbohydrates, but we will cover the rest on separate videos on this channel. So subscribe and hit the bell button so you don't miss a thing. And of course, like the video so YouTube knows that you enjoy this type of content. I will see you in the next video.